what's going on, guys? Snoring effects here are James, and today I'm showing you this intro tutorial of Cinema 4D and After Effects CC, Adobe After Effects CC. So first you want to open up a Lightroom, I'll have mine in the description below. And so once you open up the Lightroom, you'll probably have text, and you can change the text name to whatever your name's going to be. So mine's going to be It's Jex. You can do whatever you want the text to be, whatever you're making for. And see where it says font down here? You can go to whatever font you want. It comes with all these fonts, except some of them I download myself. And you can find a tutorial on that on YouTube if you want to. And I'm gonna go to GoGo Poster Punch. Just makes it look way better. So you'll have its circle and a camera. So, hit the circle. Move it so you can move the camera wherever you want it to be. So you're gonna go to frame 0 down here and hit this key button that makes a keyframe. So you're gonna go down to 60 and make it go probably like right about here. And you can tell it goes this. Also, you wanna go 60 and make this frame thing 0. So frame circle to 360. So it's exactly 360 keyframe. And also make the regular 360 stack. Okay, keyframe. Then you get this. That's pretty nice. So you go 270 keyframe, 300, make it sort of go out, and then go back. And this. Oh, don't forget, you go this thing. And if the old frames, you turn that off, so then it just goes as fast as it will go in reality. And I'm gonna stop. So that's a bad thing. Go like this. And so just maybe just move the green and make it go like that. Now let's see how this looks. It still does that. So if it keeps doing that, you wanna go to about like 180. Just make it go like that. So once you got that, you want to get some materials. So I usually get like a sort of like darker color on the outside, because there'll be in and out of there. So I'm going to be in there, I'll get a lighter color. Go like that, go like that. Then you get an intro, animation text intro, and it looks like this. Pretty awesome. You can always just click this button up here to see what it looks like in reality time. It looks pretty nice if you ask me. So then you want to add a bit more to it. So you can open it. And you can go to, this box and go to Sweet Nerves. You go to this tool thing and get a circle and get whatever should be on it. So let's say I'm going to make a star. Circle into the screen there, it's under, right under the screen. Put the star under it, so you get this thing. I usually get out the white box on the camera. So you get this huge star, which is annoying. And then you can just click in this circle, make the radius down to 8 or 12. I usually use it. So you make the rotation of it. Excuse me. That, it's nice. But I want to do is increase the sweet nerve so it goes around the tiny toe checks. So you just select this tool right here and just keep dragging it out so it makes it bigger. Bigger, smaller, however you like. Personally, I like one bigger. So you get that. Your camera is still hopping, you just don't have the camera selected, so it's easier to use to make sweet nerves. So then you go to the sweet nerve actual thing. You go to frame 0. And then make the star growth 100 keyframe. Then you go to about like 150 keyframe. Then you go to 170. Make the star growth to 0 keyframe. And go back to 150. Forget all that. And you go to 140. Have your auto keyframe, which is those like rotate thing. You go there and you make the star growth. You just put just put 100 right there. You go to 160 or 170, whatever you prefer. I prefer 170. Then you start up all the way down. You go back to 140. Work that time, okay. If it doesn't work, you usually go back to 140. Sorry about that. When you go back to 140, you have to start the back to 100. So you just select that, make it go to 100. Get that, and you have your star. You can make it go away, so I would compute keyframe and make it go to 0 at the start growth at 240, and at 260, I'll make the end growth down to 0. Yeah, see the end growth number. So you go 240, make the end growth 100. So now it starts to go away right at that frame. So you can add a color to that, just like how you can add a color to the other frame. So I'm gonna make it a cracked purple, and you can see how good it looks by just looking at that. So then you're gonna wanna render it out. So you go to the render settings, which is right here. You click that, go to output, and you have that. I prefer to make the width 1280 and the height 720. And height 72. So then you go to save, and you can just make a file on your desktop real quick. There you got that. Make a file on your desktop, so I'm going to name this new folder. Name the folder, rename. Rename to, let's just make it, it's and then you can go back to Cinema 4D, go to File, and you can find It's Jex on your desktop. It's Jex. You're in the file, and you go to File Name, and make it just whatever you want to name the file, so it's named Text. Then you're done with the text part, so you hit this and start rendering. So I'm just going to speed up the render part. Well, I'm just going to edit it out, but pretty much it will render, and then it'll go up make sure your camera's back on before you do that. So make sure you put your camera back on, then you start rendering. So I'll be back once this is done rendering.
Once you get to After Effects, you want to go to Composition, New Composition. Click that, and just whatever, make this 1280 by 720.
You.
So you press the star button on your keyboard wherever you want a keyframe. Make sure you have the music selected. So I have a keyframe there, wherever it goes high. So right here, there'll be a keyframe. Right here, there'll be... Okay. Alright. Here we go here. Keyframe that. Keyframe that. Keyframe that. Keyframe that. This is higher, so then I would say go right here. Put a star. 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 Actually, no, I want to say put a star there. Control Z. And star. 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 Let's just, and then, okay, I think that's all the keyframes are going to want. So you go to your text. Then drag down, go transform, and then you go onto this keyframe and hit scale at 100, and then go hit this button right here to go to the next frame, and you make the scale and put it to 120. Then you copy, do select it, and just go like that, control C, and you go to the next one, and you do control V, and do it on all of them. Control V, control V, control V, control V. Control V, and don't forget, Control V. So if you render the sound run preview, it'll start bumping to the beat, hopefully, if you synced right. You got to I messed up. Right here, you do want to sync it. So instead of just having to make all those, you can just do Control V wherever you want to now, because you're a free man, and you just hit the basic keyframing. Yeah, right here I think would be a nice cute Control Z, go back a frame, Control V, and then render it out. You got to okay, then you want to do the last syncing at the end. Control V, Control V, Control V, Control V, Control V. Don't forget Control V. Should ran preview that. And you got to got that. So then you wanna layer new solid. Dark gray solid, hit OK. This is where you wanna install trap code particular. You start, go to effects prefix, search up particular trap code, and then drag and drop that onto the dark gray solid. So then you go all the way right here and go to emitter and hit see this little clock, hit that, change this to 100 to 5000, and you gotta go ahead 5 frames, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 by clicking this button 5 times, and particle second, 0, and you see right here like this mountains, you increase that, hit. And on the dark gray solid, hit U. So you see these two keyframes, move the red like rectangle to where the second keyframe is right there. So you can get out of the mountain form, and then you should have particles. But then first we're gonna go to emitter type, right over where the emitter was, and then make it to box. So where it says direction, I usually make mine go bi-directional, and emitter size, make it about 5,000 each. You just Control V, Control V. So you get that. Go to particle. And make the life go to like a second more than it is, or like 2 seconds more is what I usually do. And the particle type, make it cloudlet. And size, increase that until you just see all like white or whatever color yours is. Oh, we haven't changed the color sets. So you see all white. And versus opacity, make that the 1 or 2, whatever one you think looks better. But first, you want to go to color. You see this little like dabber. You click whatever color you want at the base. I say that looks like a good color, yeah. With this, I think I want the opacity 1. Yeah, opacity 1 looks good. So then it takes a while more to render, so as I render. Okay, so then. Fun fact, as well as watching Karate Kid. Okay, just wait for this. Just wait, keep syncing. And then the tripod form, it's a particular, sorry. It takes one to render because it's awesome. So, I'm waiting for it to render. It does take a while to render. It doesn't take you just 5 seconds to make a little text animation. It might take just 10 seconds or whatever you want it to be long. It still takes a while. Don't underestimate the time, because it takes pretty long. A lot of time. Oh, wait, you want to listen to music, so. So then you pretty much your syncing is going. That happens, so you have your awesome syncing, and awesome decks, and awesome star, and awesome background, and your awesome long render, too. Sometime. Come on, you're gonna want to install the S plugin, so go to S, underscore below, drag that right onto your text. Color, you want to make it go to the same color as you probably did the background. So then, you want to make it. Wait, do I have truffle shine? Because it's easier to teach. Oh, yes, I do. Just forget all the S glow crap. Okay, I'm going to delete it. Right click. Control X. Okay, so get truffle shine, drag and drop it onto your text. So then you look at that, it looks pretty ugly, but you go to transfer mode, make that add, colorize, you just want to go to colorize, one color, and you see the one color, you drag that, and make it like whatever color you want that I think looks good. So you have to render that out, render that again. That takes a while. It takes even longer because you have that shining, but it makes it look awesome. Wait, 5 seconds, like 144 frames. Yes. 7 seconds almost. Nine seconds. Okay, that's finally almost done. Like 2 seconds, 1, 2. You got to hit my There we go. So you got swag control. I preset with it. Nice swag. Oh, are you kidding me? We get to render it again. In a piece inside. So then after this, you're pretty much done. I know, right?
What do you like? Long. Interest can take a long time. Don't underestimate them. Die. Six. Spare is just wasting time. Seven. Come on, 7.5. Eight. After this, you're gonna, export the file. Make it so you have that. And you're pretty much done. I know, right? Pretty happy. Yeah, no? Okay, then. Yay! Okay, then. You got to. So you go to file in the top left corner, export, add a render queen. I'll app it to you. You go to your desktop and just name it. I'll just name it get wrecked, you know. And then you hit render and then you're done. What's up and bye.